Some Phobos armor-wearing lieutenants work behind enemy lines as skilled assassins and intelligence gatherers. In this guide, we'll be showing you how to paint this lieutenant, ready to collect incredible tactical data on the gaming table in no time. If you're new to painting, you can check out the Citadel Colour Painting Essentials videos to learn more about it. The paints we've used in this guide are listed on screen now. We're painting in the colours of the Ultramarines, but remember, you can paint your miniatures however you like. Also on screen now is any additional equipment we've used. This includes brushes and mediums. Again, however, feel free to use whichever brushes you're most comfortable with, and if you don't have mediums at home, you could use water instead. So to start off this guide, we've undercoated this model, and we've done this in Macrag Blue. This will give us a great head start on that blue armour. Also, you'll need a pot of Macrag Blue to hand. This will help us tidy up any mistakes later on in the process. The first paint we're going to use is Abaddon Black. We'll be using this on the undersuit, gun casing, and the various straps and pouches you can see on the miniature. There are quite a lot of black details on this miniature. You can refer back to the box art to check where to place colours if you're ever unsure, or just choose for yourself. Abaddon Black is a base paint, so we need to thin it down with some water on our palette and then apply it to the miniature in a couple of thin layers. Doing this avoids clogging up any of that detail we can see on the miniature. We're using a medium layer brush here. It's small enough to get into those tricky to reach areas and large enough that we can paint a little bit quicker with it. Next, we're going to use Celestra Grey, and we'll be painting the rocks in this colour. Apply this just like you did the Abaddon Black, thinning it down and applying a few layers. Just take your time and try not to get any on the feet of the miniature. If you do, just use Macrag Blue and tidy back up. Now we'll be using Mournfang Brown to paint some leather details. You'll see that it's just the strap across the main body that we're painting this colour. Again, apply a couple of layers and take your time around the details we've already painted. Now this lieutenant has been very busy slaughtering some Tyranids, so let's paint those details now. We can see that he's wearing a Tyranid carapace as a shoulder pad. For this, we'll be painting it in Naggaroth Knight. We'll also be painting the Tyranid on the base in this colour too. Naggaroth Knight is a base paint, but it's quite a thin one, so we'll need to apply a couple of layers. And once those first few base coats are done, we can see the miniature really starting to come together. Now we'll be using Wraithbone to paint the tentacles of the Tyranid on the base. We'll also be using this to paint those brains that we can see have been stomped on by our lieutenant. Again, this will take a few coats to cover over that blue undercoat, so just take your time and build up the layers. And with that done, we'll move on to Bugman's Glow for the skin. We're painting to tie in with the box art, but feel free to choose whichever skin tone you prefer. When you're painting faces and skin, it's really important to keep that paint thin. But make sure it's not too watery. We don't want it to separate when we apply it to the miniature. We want the paint thin enough so that it just glides nicely off the brush. Then we can apply a few layers of the paint to the miniature. Now we'll be using Jean Stealer Purple, and we'll be painting the blood on the blade and also those suckers on those tentacles on the base. This is a layer paint, but we can absolutely use it to base coat too. Just apply it in the same way as the others, thinning it down and applying a few layers. You might find it just needs an extra layer to get that full coverage. Adding this colour in just adds a little bit of variety to the miniature. Now we'll be starting off the metallic details using Lead Belcher for the silver areas. This is a metallic base paint. We apply it just like the others, thinning it down and applying a few layers. Make sure it's not too watery as it will separate on the miniature, and this will take us longer to paint in the long run. Once again, you can refer to the box art to check where to place certain colours, or you can choose for yourself. There's quite a lot of metallic details on this miniature to cover. Now it's time to add in that gold that the Ultramarines are famous for. We'll be using Retributor armour to paint in these details. It's quite normal for paints to separate in the pot when they've been stood for a while, so make sure you give it a good shake before you use it. We'll be using Retributor armour to paint the trim and some of the iconography. You'll see that there's just a few details on the miniature that we haven't painted yet. We'll be painting these in Balthazar Gold. This adds a different tone of gold, which really helps to add some variety and breaks up all those metallics. We'll also be adding the same wash over both golds, and doing this will help tie everything together. And for the final base coat, we're going to use Mephiston Red. We'll just be picking out the tube and some of those screens here too. This is a nice bright red, which stands out from the rest of the colours. Just take your time and be careful around the armour that we've already painted. If you do need to tidy up, just make sure you thin down that Macrag Blue first. And once you've done that, all your base coats are finished. So now we can move on to adding some shades and contrasts. The first shade we'll be using is Reikland Flesh Shade, and we'll just apply this over that skin. This'll add some nice, subtle depth. When you're applying shades, do it heavily and neatly, being careful to control any excess pooling. If you find it is pooling too much, just clean off your brush and use that to soak up any excess. Now we'll move on to Agrax Earthshade, and we'll be using this in a couple of different ways. Firstly, we'll be thinning it down with Larmier Medium. So that'll be one part Larmier Medium to one part Agrax Earthshade. And we'll be using this to carefully put it into the recesses of the skin. This includes the eyes and into those scars as well. Doing this adds depth and also avoids us needing to paint those eyes. However, adding a shade into those eye sockets is a great way to quickly get those models on the gaming table. Next, we're going to take Agrax Earthshade straight from the pot, and we'll be applying this onto any brown leather and also the gold areas. This includes the Balthazar gold and the Retributor armour areas. You'll notice that this adds lots of depth, and the model is really starting to come together. The next thing we're going to do is use Basilicanum Grey and Contrast Medium. Again, we'll be using this in a few different ways. Firstly, we'll thin it down using one part contrast medium to one part Basilicanum Grey. Then we'll apply this over the silver details. We'll also be using this on the red and the rocks. You might notice that this is a contrast paint, but many contrast paints are really good as shades when we thin them down. Using a paint in a variety of different ways achieves lots of different effects on the miniature, and it's a great way to get the most out of one paint. Then we're going to take two parts contrast medium and one part Basilicanum Grey and mix that together. We'll be applying this onto the ends of the blood on the blade. We want to go about halfway up. And once that's dry, we'll then apply a second coat, but starting further down. And once that's dry, we'll apply another layer, this time taking it straight from the pot and just dabbing it carefully onto the very ends of the blood. Doing this just creates a quick and easy gradient. But if you don't feel like doing it, just apply the Basilicanum Grey all over the blood instead. Just remember to thin it down first, as we don't want it to completely overpower that Gene Stealer purple. And the last way we're going to use Basilicanum Grey is as a recess shade. We'll be using this for the armour and also that Tyranid carapace. Recess shading just means applying a shade, or in this case a contrast paint, directly into the recesses of a miniature. If we applied the paint all over the flat surfaces of the armour, for example, it would change the overall colour. All we actually want to do is add depth to the recesses, so doing this means we don't have to spend time layering back up later. To do this, we'll take Basilicanum Grey straight from the pot, and with a small layer brush, just drop it neatly into those panel lines. This is both on the Tyranid carapace and also on the armour. Take your time and work your way around the miniature, just picking out all of those lines. If you do make any mistakes, don't worry, just tidy back up with the previous colours. This will take a little bit of time, but it's absolutely worth it. Now we're going to paint that Tyranid flesh using Magos Purple and Contrast Medium. Add two parts Contrast Medium to one part Magos Purple, and then apply it quite heavily all over those tentacles. Just like before, if you do find it pooling too much anywhere, just clean off your brush and use that to soak up the excess. You'll see that this creates a really quick and easy Tyranid flesh. Now it's time to paint those brains. We'll be using Calgar Blue thinned down with Larmier Medium. Calgar Blue is a layer paint, but when we thin it down with Larmier Medium, we can create a shade consistency. Then we can apply it just like we do a normal shade. What this will do is add the depth to the recesses without changing the surfaces too much. We'll be using three parts Larmier Medium to one part Calgar Blue. And then we can apply it heavily and neatly over those brains, and you'll see that it adds this really cool blue effect. Now your lieutenant is more than ready to deploy behind enemy lines and send them into disarray. However, if you'd like to see an easy way to taint this paint job up a notch, stick with us. Now to make that blood on the blade look fresh and gooey, we're going to add Ardcoat to it. Ardcoat is a gloss varnish, so it'll make it look wet and oozing. Just be careful not to apply it too heavily, as it can discolour that base coat underneath. For the last part of this guide, we'll be applying an edge highlight to that armour. For this, we'll use Calgar Blue again. However, this time, we'll just thin it down with some water and apply it as we normally would. When you're edge highlighting, it's best to use the edge of your brush where you can. Make sure you've got a really stable painting position and just carefully run the edge of your brush along those sharp edges of the panels. Doing this creates a quick and easy highlight, and the brush does all the work for you. When you're thinning your paint on the palette, make sure that it glides nicely off the brush. We don't want to thin it too much, as if it's too watery, it won't sit on the miniature correctly. You can do as much or as little edge highlighting as you want. You might only want to pick out the most prominent areas. This would be areas like the backpack and the knees. Just work your way around the miniature, picking out as many edges as you'd like. And if you make any mistakes, just tidy back up with the other colours. And there we are, your lieutenant is finished, ready to work tactically to guarantee the success of a Space Marine force. You can see that we've applied transfers and we've also based our model. We've based it using a technical paint called Armageddon Dust. And if you'd like to learn more about technical paints, you can check out our video all about them. For more tutorials, tips and tricks, you can head to your local Warhammer store where our amazing staff will be more than happy to help you. Or head on over to citadelcolour.com. Well, we hope you've enjoyed the video and we'll see you next time. Bye!